All right, we're going to do some more puzzles and riddles where you need to find more than one thing, but you could still use one variable. Kim is 2 years older than 3 times Amy's age, and their ages add up to 98. Find their ages. Okay, so obviously Kim's older than Amy because you're going to multiply by 3 and add 2, right? 2 years older than 3 times Amy. So remember, we're going to start off by defining their ages, so Amy's age and Kim's age. And so Kim, we could figure out what hers is if we knew what Amy's age was. So the key is to let our single variable, in other words, just one letter, represent Amy's age. So how about A? So remember, A is going to stand for Amy's age. So Kim's age, it's 2 years older. That means you're going to add 2 to something, right? So you're going to add 2. 2 years older than 3 times Amy's age. Now, if Amy's A, 3 times her age is going to be 3A plus 2. So we've got Amy's age and we have Kim's age. Now we're going to add their 2 ages together. So we're going to take an Amy's age, right? It's really telling us that her age, right, whatever that is, plus Kim's age. We know that's going to add up to 98, so you can sort of think of this as kind of a cross between words and algebra. So let's plug in what Amy's age is. It's just A, so we could write A plus, now Kim's age is 3A plus 2, so I could write 3A plus 2. So in other words, there's Amy's age, there's Kim's age, and it adds up to 98. All right, so now we could solve this by adding like terms over on the left-hand side. 4a plus 2 is 98. And let's subtract 2 from both sides. So we get 4a is 96. And let's divide both sides by 4. So I think that's 24. A is 24. We'll see if I did that right. So if a is 24, then Amy's age is 24, right? And how would I get Kim's age? Well, I'd do 3a plus 2. So I'd have to do 3 times 24, right? So I have to do 24 times 3, which is 72, and add 2 more to it. So Kim is 74. All right, now let's see if this makes sense given the original word problem. So Kim is 2 years older than 3 times Amy's age. Is that true? Is 74 two more than 3 times Amy's age? Well, yes, actually, over here, right there is where we showed it. We did 3 times Amy's age and added 2. Also, do their ages add up to 98? Well, let's check that out. Is 24 and 74 98? Yes. So now we know that it's correct. We could write down the answer. Amy is 24 years old, and Kim is 74 years old. And there you have it. Okay, here's a more advanced one. Nolan has 5 more quarters than dimes and 7 fewer nickels than dimes. He has 25 coins. How many of each coin does he have? And how much money in dollars and cents is it worth? Well, this is a pretty involved problem here. So, first of all, it wants to know how many of each coin does he have? Now, what kind of coins are we talking about? We've got quarters, dimes, and nickels. So I'm not sure what I'm going to let my variable be, but let's just write down, we're going to have to define the number of quarters, the number of dimes, and the number of nickels. All right, now the tricky part is deciding which one you're just going to let be a simple variable like x. He has 5 more quarters than dimes. So in order to know how many quarters he has, we have to know how many dimes. Okay, so I know I'm not going to start off with the quarters. He also has 7 fewer nickels than dimes. So to figure out how many nickels, We also need to know what the dimes are. So the natural choice then would let the dimes, let's use D, how many dimes he has. Because to figure out the quarters or nickels, I have to know what we're going to use for dimes. So I've got D is the number of dimes. And actually, I should have written number of quarters, dimes, and nickels. So he's got five more quarters than dimes. All right, so for the quarters, he's got five more. D plus five will be the number of quarters. He's got seven fewer nickels. That means he has to subtract seven from how many dimes. So however many dimes he has seven fewer. That'll give you D minus seven. Now, this is the number. This doesn't talk about how much they're worth. This is the number of quarters, dimes, and nickels. So first of all, we could figure out how many coins he has. We know it's 25, so we know that if we add up the number of quarters plus the number of dimes plus the number of nickels, that adds up to a total of 25 coins. So we're going to take the number of quarters, right, plus the number of dimes plus the number of nickels, and that should add up to 25. So we don't need the parentheses, but I wanted to show you that I'm just writing the number of quarters plus the number of dimes plus the number of nickels. So we could take those parentheses off now. And this would be your equation. If you want, you can sort of say there's how many quarters, how many dimes, how many nickels. All right, so now let's simplify the left-hand side. We've got d, 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 3d, right? And then I have to add the 5 and minus 7. That's minus 2 is 25. And we're going to add 2. So I have 3d is 27. And if I divide both sides by 3, I'll have d equals 9. Now, if you get a fraction or some decimal, that would make sense. You can't have part of a dime. So either they gave you a bogus problem, or there's, you did something wrong if you don't get a whole number here for how many dimes. You also can't have a negative number, right? You can't have like negative 5 dimes. All right, so if d is 9, let's go back up here. If d is 9, then if I put in 9 for d, I've got 14 quarters, right? And let's see, d is 9, so I've got 9 dimes. And putting in 9 for the nickels, I've got 2 nickels. And then we want to make sure, does that really give me 25 coins? And if we add those up, 14, 9, and 2, it is. So this is going to be our first answer. How many of each do I have? So that's the first question. I've got 14 quarters, 9 dimes, and 2 nickels. All right, next part of the problem was how much is it worth? Well, how much are 14 quarters worth? Okay, I'm going to just say, well, the quarters, you've got 14 quarters, and how much is each quarter worth? It's worth 25 cents. So what's that going to be? $3.50. And how many dimes do I have? I've got 9 dimes. Each dime is worth 10 cents. So I've got 90 cents in dimes. And nickels, I've got 2 nickels. Each are worth 5 cents. So I've got 10 cents in nickels. So nothing surprising here. $4.10. I'm sorry. I did that wrong. $4.50. So we would say the coins are worth $4.50. Now, what I suggest you do is go back to the original problem, write down the problem, and try doing it all on your own on a piece of paper and see if you can get the same answer. And if not, go back to this video and check it out. So here was the original problem. No one has 5 more quarters. You just write down the problem. Then see how you would define your variables, write your equation, solve your equation, answer the question. So we've got two answers, 14 quarters, 9 dimes, and 2 nickels. was the first part of the problem, and the second part is how much was it worth? The coins are worth $4.50.